Communities in the Caribbean are bracing for the impact, and they have shelters that are set up on the various islands in the path of this storm.
Yeah, and that's where our hearts are right now this morning. We're thinking about all the people right there in the brunt of this storm, and you're getting some firsthand information, Sheldon.
Yeah, we have a lot of family who live in Grenada, and I've just kind of been monitoring the social media feeds and seeing some of the damage. Thankfully, everyone in my family is accounted for, but everyone is just kind of shocked that the storm formed this early. A lot of them usually expect storms around mid-August, and now they're getting them in late June. So that's kind of been the big takeaway from all of this.
Yeah, it really does make a lot of people wonder what hurricane season is going to look like for us throughout 2024. All right. And we turn our attention now to meteorologist Kelly in classes. You keep tracking Hurricane Beryl.
Yeah, and very interesting developments with this. So Hurricane Beryl right now, winds of 165 miles per hour, quickly moving to the west northwest at 22 miles per hour. But notice that pressure, 935 millibars. The hurricane hunters are flying through the storm, and if this is confirmed through a drop zone, they're finding a pressure of 928 millibars, which obviously signifies that this is strengthening, but also, this could potentially break the lowest pressure in July for a storm, which would beat out Emily back in 2005. Now, the first pass of the Hurricane Hunter is finding winds even stronger of at least 160 knots. They're going to do that second pass where the Air Force Hurricane Hunters are going to fly through that storm as well. This is the 5 a.m. advisory from the National Hurricane Center. The core of the storm stays south of Hispaniola, but they're still expected to see those strong winds as well as heavy rainfall. And I'm really worried about Jamaica. They are expected to potentially see a direct impact with this. As it moves towards the Yucatan Peninsula, it will make landfall on Friday morning as a Category 1 hurricane and then emerge out in the Gulf of Mexico later on this weekend. Now, I am also keeping a close eye on the Gulf of Mexico because the latest models are in and they're starting to trend more north, so they're starting to curve, which could be a big concern for parts of the Texas Gulf Coast and maybe the Louisiana Gulf Coast. Now, it's not going to be as strong as what it is now, but definitely something to watch over the next couple of runs. We'll continue to watch those trends. Back at home, we're watching rain. We'll have more of those details coming up in a few minutes.